question. In his interview on Sky tonight with Nigel Farage from GB News, Donald Trump said Prince Harry could also be in trouble. When Harry and Meghan Markle moved to the US, you see, Harry had to fill in visa forms that ask, well, have you ever taken drugs? And you can get banned from entering the country if you say yes. Did Harry lie? Because as Harry actually admitted last year in his autobiography, Spare, he's actually taken cocaine, marijuana, magic mushrooms. And Trump was asked about that by Nigel Farage.
If he's lied on his visa form, doesn't the truth need to come out?
Should
he get special privileges that nobody else does?
No, and we'll have to see if they know something about the drugs, and if he lied, he'll have to take appropriate action.
Appropriate action?
Yeah.
Which might mean not staying
in America. Oh, I don't know. You'll have to tell me.
Joining me from London is Patrick Christys, star presenter on GB News as well as Nigel Farage. Patrick, how much trouble is Prince Harry in, do you think?
Well, he's potentially in a world of trouble, actually, isn't he, really? Because if he has lied about his drug use on his visa form, then, frankly, we'll have to be treated like everybody else. I would quite like to see these visa forms, because I wouldn't be surprised if it turns out he filled it out in crayon and Meghan stuck it on the fridge for a couple of weeks before they submitted it. He used to have people filling out these forms for him when he was a member of the royal family, so he could have leant on that. But this time now, it looks as though he's been left to his own devices and may well have lied. The only issue is that we don't really want him back. But I was thinking that maybe we could come up with some kind of swap deal for Donald Trump. They can take back all of the Americans that we have shouting on public transport and in restaurants over here, and we will have Prince Harry, but they have to keep Meghan Markle. That would, I think, be a fair swap deal for us. But Prince Harry would come back. He would also come back with a fatwa on his head because of the other stuff he put in Spare about how many members of the Taliban he killed. So all in all, that book has got him into a heck of a lot of trouble.